It's a kind of magic.
I'm the invisible man.
Incredible how you can.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy?
We've all had ego problems, like any other group. But we've never actually let it go that far where we actually said, okay, let's forget it. Because I think we've all, the four of us, have actually said that this chemistry that's worked has really worked for us. And so why, you know, why kill the goose that laid the golden egg? And it's a survival instinct that I have in me, and I think the whole group has. And through anything, we will just carry on until... You know, one of us drops dead or something, you know, just we'll just replace. I mean, if I suddenly left, I mean, I think they have the sort of mechanism in them, you know, they just replace me, you know. Not easy to replace me, huh?
One of the most successful British rock bands ever lost its lead singer in November 1991. With 21 years and 19 albums behind them, Queen had had a phenomenal reign, but there were still some surprises to come. Brian May, Freddie Mercury, Roger Taylor and John Deacon were intensely competitive individuals. Perhaps that was the most important part of their chemistry as a band. That, their talent, and of course a little bit of luck. Brian May.
There aren't very many sort of real groups born every day. That's definitely true. And obviously there's a fantastic amount of luck involved. By some strange process, we came together, and it was a very efficient little machine, you know, four people who certainly viewed from the outside would be seen as a very efficient machine. They're all kicking the shit out of each other inside the machine, but from the outside, there's no doubt that everything was there. We had the skills to cover every area, and you couldn't put that together from the outside. You couldn't make it happen, really. I think there has to be the element of luck, really.
She keeps them always on in a pretty cabinet. Mm. Decorate cakes, she says, just like Marie Antoinette.